Hello scientists, welcome back to my channel. I haven't seen you guys for a while because life has been quite busy. I am going to upload regularly again. I'll be posting a video every week. I'm also live streaming every week. Make sure you leave the topics you'd like to see in the comment below. Also follow my social media so you can keep track of the live stream and posting schedule. Without further ado, let's start to draw our immune checkpoint.
First, let's make the tumor cell. So make an ellipse. I usually use this dark gray as the outline. Also make it thin. 0.5 thickness. So this is an ellipse. Let's fill in with the color. Let's switch to the fill color control because it's a cancer cell. So let's use a little bit like a dirty yellow. And I'll make a copy of this and send it to the back. Now make it into a circle and place it here. So this is like lower half of the cell. We have a cross section about this size. This part I will fade it out later to maybe a little bit more view on top. We see more of the inside of the cell. Make another copy and scale it down. Now we'll remove the outline, change its color to gray. Come up here to add an effect into this ellipse. When you open the effect window, you will find effects that you can choose to implement into your fill. And in this case, I will use the film grain. Now we have this grainy fill inside of our nucleus. So it looks like there's some chromatin in there. I think I should use a lighter yellow here. It just makes things look cleaner. I will add a radial gradient into the cell to get a little bit of volume. There's a gradient in there and you got this volume. And I will also make a little bit of transparency so you can see the lower half of your nucleus. This goes on top. So I'm adding the lower half, the cell. Let me add a darker color. You can see it. This can go. I will delete that. Okay, so now it looks like this half is floating on top of our cytosol. I will add a radial gradient. Now the color is wrong. We need these gray. And like this lighter gray. Now I have three color points and then I will decrease its opacity and I'll make it around 20% and also this one around 20%. You can see that you get some transparency here. As you can see, because of the transparency, you can create this illusion that immersing underneath the cytosol. If you want to have a better top-down view, you can just increase the width of your ellipse. The next thing that we can do is the immune cell, like the T cell thing over here. And actually you can just copy your tumor cell and shrink it down. And I will come over here to crystallize tool. Hold Alt to enlarge the brush. And when you click on these, then you can make these the extrusions. And then I'll switch to the direct selection tool. I can round the corners. I'll draw a new cell body here with an ellipse and then send it to the back. Add a few more anchor points and drag it around, distort it so it can fit to the overall shape of these extrusions. Radial gradient, of course. And that's too saturated. I will lighten it up. And also here, I'll just drop in. And for a nucleus, I can also just make it slightly larger and switch it to, but this is too dark, too saturated. Lighten it up, then you can see the grains. And move it over here, drop it in. And do you see these microtubule filaments? You can also create them. I'm making a path with a white stroke. Make it thicker. I'll change it to width profile 1. Let me go to effect blur, Gaussian blur. And with Gaussian blur, you see the stroke is blurry. You know, it looks a little bit fuzzy. Click OK, decrease the opacity. Then you can get that and some filaments in your cell. I will need to add some pseudopodia onto our T cell. I'll create an ellipse and delete one anchor point. Make it a little bit longer. And now when you connect it to the cell, then it starts to look like a pseudopodia. But I will turn these parts. The connection here looks very awkward. You need to change the gradient a little bit. I will add one more stop here and make the opacity zero. Seamlessly blend in, but there's a problem at the tip. So what you can do is to move the radius of your radial gradient a little bit, adjust it so now you can hide that part, same time make the gradient a little bit bigger. There you go, that's your pseudopodia. Okay, now the receptors, PD1 and PDL1. First, let me draw an ellipse, rectangle tool with a rectangle, and I will use the Pathfinder tool to merge these two shapes. I just make a copy of it, place it on top, switch it to a darker blue, and you can have the thickness of your receptor. And there's some perspective you need to take care of. There's like perspective involved to add a new anchor point here and place it here. Then you can have the thickness PDL1 on the tumor for the PD1 receptor. When you make these 3D things, then there's like this perspective you need to take care of. Okay, one moment, let me first move it here so we have more space. With PD1, need to adjust the perspective. There we go. Just checking with the perspective plan. I need to remove this anchor point because I only need these parts down here. Okay. Okay, I also need a block over here. In your view. I also need to crop it. So you guys see that it's a lot of work to create 3D illustration in Adobe Illustrator. That's why I've been avoiding to do that. But okay, go to the Pathfinder tool and click on minus front. Switch it to here to this one. Okay, I need to change the color of PD1 and PDL1. Yeah, this is a happier color. Okay, and let me also drop the white color here. Yeah, that's too saturated. Let me dim it down a little bit. This is good. Also, just less saturation. Okay, yeah, I think that's better. Okay, and this one, let me see, which one should we use? I think orange is a better choice here then. But desaturated one like this. There's also something I need to fix here, which is these two sections of the color should be different. This part needs to be at least one shade darker. Okay, like that. So it's really subtle. The devils are in the details, as they say. Good. And then here. Don't you guys see? This is so much work to create something 3D, blend into the cytosol. How do we do that? Let's make a copy of the cross-section ellipse, make it black, and move it to the top. Now select your surface antigen and select both of them, go to opacity, make mask, and uncheck clip. The part that's within the cytosol, now it's completely gone. But we want to see a little bit of it. So go to opacity mask, switch to the mask mode, and decrease the opacity of the mask to about 80%. Then you get to see a little bit surface antigen while the rest of the part is outside. Okay, now switch back to the stop editing opacity mask mode. Okay, now we need to do the same with the T cell. So let me first ungroup everything. Control C, Control V to get this shape right on top. Black, move all right on top. Now select the PDL one, go to opacity, make mask, uncheck the clip, switch to the mask mode, opacity to 80%. Okay, now you can exit the mask mode. There we go. I want to fade this part out a little bit, so I will also use the opacity mask. This time I'll create a shape like this. Okay, and I'll go to Effect, Blur, Gaussian Blur to make the edges blurry. Click OK. Move it approximately somewhere here. Everything in the cell, group them. Select the mask. Again, make mask. Uncheck the clip. Then you can fade out the part of the cell. It creates an atmosphere. That's really nice. Oh, thank you. And now we can make a background. Create a new layer, drop underneath, background. I'll go with the current nature review style. They really like these earth tone these days. Now I will do a little bit of labeling. And I'll create a new layer and also lock the cell. Then this can be tumor cell. And a lot of you guys have asked me which font you should use. And most of them recommend to use Arial or Helvetica. These are graphical abstract, they don't want you to make it too exciting. So just the regular stuff. Of course, if you want to create some shadow underneath here, you can also do that. If the shadow is missing, then things look very weird. You know, just even if it's very, very light. Once you add it, everything makes more sense visually. There you go. This is our Adobe Illustrator Advanced Live section.